going to brief on malicious program. Basically, backdoor, logic bomb, Trojan, mobile code, and zombie. So let's start with the backdoor or a trapdoor. This particular malicious software is nothing but a secret entry point into a program which allows someone who is aware of the backdoor to gain access into the system without going through the usual security access procedures. These backdoors or trapdoors are actually utilized while developing a software or while debugging a software in the production level of the software. It is used legitimately for many years to debug and test the programs. In such a case, a backdoor is called as maintenance hook. So as already specified, this is usually created while developing an application which has an authentication procedure or which requires a long setup. So every time a developer wants to do something, he did not get into this authentication procedure. So he is given some special privileges to avoid all these necessary steps for setting up and authentication and directly enter into the system and develop the software. The backdoor is code actually that recognizes some special sequence of input, or it is triggered by being run from a certain user ID or by any unlikely sequence of events. These backdoors become threats when unscrupulous programmers use them to gain unauthorized access. Some examples of the backdoors are, for example, in movie War Games, which was released in 1983, the architect of the computer system in this movie had inserted a hard-coded password which gave the user access to the system. In January 2014, a backdoor was discovered in certain Samsung Android products like the Galaxy devices through which the remote access of the data was being done from the mobile phones. In 2019, Y company, which developed 5G technology, was suspected to have a backdoor entry, but it is unproven. Many countries suspected that it is having a backdoor. So, however, in some of the articles or channels, the managing director told that, you know, there is no such backdoor entry in the 5G technology. So if you observe this diagram, this gives a depiction of how the backdoors are created. This is the victim machine in which a backdoor is there in the system. Through this backdoor, the attacker gains access, who is an unauthorized user, gains access and does malicious activities. So next one is logical bomb. This logic bomb is nothing but it is a code embedded in some legitimate program, that is authorized program. This authorized program which has this code will explode when certain conditions are met, or it is triggered when certain events happen. Certain examples of the condition which can be used as triggers for this logic bomb may be presence or absence of certain files, or a particular day of the week or date, or a particular user running the application. Once this bomb is triggered, it may alter or delete the data or delete entire files, or it may cause a machine to halt or do some other damage. So normally hackers hide these logic bombs in computer viruses, worms and Trojan horses. Certain examples are given here for logic bombs. In 1996 in USA, Omega Engineering Company was derailed in its corporate growth strategy. That is, you know, some of the operation software was deleted, and that eventually led to the layoff of the workers due to the logic bomb unleashed by a fired employee. So a fired employee put a logic bomb inside that software, and at a particular time it exploded and all the operation software was deleted. In Seoul, South Korea, Wednesday, March 20, 2013, logic bomb exploded. So The computer networks at two major South Korean banks and three top TV broadcasters went into shutdown mode en masse, paralyzing bank machines across the country. So you can see here pictorial flowchart depiction. If the condition is fulfilled, yes, then the bomb is activated. Otherwise, it goes down to next operation. Let's look at the TrojanHorse. TrojanHorse seems to be a useful program or a command procedure, but even though it is useful, it contains hidden code which, when invoked, performs some unwanted or harmful function. So these programs, TrojanHorse programs, can be used to accomplish functions indirectly that an unauthorized user could not accomplish directly. For example, to gain access to the files of another user on a shared system. The another very important activity of TrojanHorse is data destruction. However, the program appears to be performing a useful function. That is, for example, let's say a calculator program. It may also be quietly doing some other function in the background, maybe deleting the user's files. There are three models of TrojanHorse, how it could be embedded. The continuing first one is where the program continues to perform the function of the original program, and along with it, it performs a separate malicious activity. The second model is the program continues to perform the function of original program, but modifying the function to perform malicious activity. For example, a Trojan version of the login program may be there which collects password. The third model is where it performs a malicious function which replaces completely the function of original program. Some examples of TrojanHorse are JUICE and ISDID. JUICE is a modular banking Trojan. This uses keystroke logging to compromise victim credentials when the user visits a bank website. ISDID is a modular banking Trojan targeting banks, payment card providers, and payroll websites. This was delivered via steganography, as the data is encrypted and encoded with the content of a valid PNG image. It was in 2019. So next comes the mobile code. This mobile code refers to the programs that can be shipped unchanged to a heterogeneous collection of platform, for example MS Windows. And when it shifts, it executes with identical semantics. So the examples of such programs may be script, macro, and other portable instruction. This mobile code is transmitted from a remote system to a local system and then executed on the local system without the user's explicit instruction. That is, without user giving the instruction, it will be automatically getting executed in the remote system. Mobile code often acts as a mechanism for a virus, worm, or TrojanHorse to be transmitted to the user's workstation. So that is, the mobile code carries viruses, worms, or TrojanHorses to wherever it is transported, and there it allows them to perform malicious activities. Mobile code takes advantage of vulnerabilities to perform its own exploits, such as unauthorized data access or compromising the root of the system. Popular vehicles that carry these mobile codes are Java applets, ActiveX, JavaScript, and VBScript. The most common ways of using mobile code for malicious operations on local system are cross-site scripting. That is where, you know, in the websites, these malicious codes are injected. Interactive and dynamic websites, it can also be transported with email attachments and downloads from untrusted sites, unsecured sites. So lastly, we have Zombie, which is a program that secretly takes over another network computer. Zombie uses this particular program to indirectly launch the attacks on the system, such as servers. It is often used to launch distributed denial of service attacks. That is, from different systems, you are trying to send requests to a particular server and blocking that server for its availability to the genuine users requesting for services. And it exploits known flaws in network systems. Some of the examples are Windigo. It's a zombie which steals credentials from infected machines, or it uses their processing power to send spams to various network systems. Another example is 3V botnet. In 2018, it infected machines, several machines, to generate fake traffic, and also it was used to steal money. So how you can actually find out your PC is a zombie? These are some of the tips to identify whether PC is a zombie. The performance of the PC is lower than usual, and it gets illogical error messages. And the system and browser crash without any reason, and your access to pages by IT security providers is blocked. So after having seen some briefings on these malicious programs, you must answer the following to check your learning outcomes. Explain a trapdoor, explain a logic bomb, explain a Trojan horse, explain a mobile code, explain a zombie.